I mentioned yesterday that there's all kinds of limitations to our freedoms. There may be social or political or economic or physical limitations to our freedom. But the good news is that freedom's definition is not a right that we have, but it's a power that lies within us. It is the power that God has given us, the reason He created us, to be rational beings, to be able to choose between good and evil. That is the power that we have, and every person has that power. We have the power to choose. But maybe we haven't spoke then about the greatest limitation. The greatest limitation that you and I have that goes against our power to choose what is good is something called concupiscence. Concupiscence is the effect of the original sin. Basically, we have within ourselves, maybe you've recognized it already within yourself, that you have a desire to do disordered things, right? It's not always easy to choose what is good, and actually, it's hard. In fact, some of the disordered things we like to choose. However, when we have a conversion moment, when we have that moment where we're like, I'm sick of doing what I ought not, right? When our moral conscience strikes us and we realize we desire something more, and all the disordered things in our life are not bringing us happiness or peace or liberty or freedom, we recognize that we want something more for ourselves. Remember that St. Paul, in his letter to the Romans, chapter 7, he talks about this lack of freedom. And he says it in maybe one of the most clear ways. He says, all the things that I desire to do, I don't do. But all the things that I hate and I don't want to do, those are the things that I end up doing. He's telling us that life is messy. We're in a battle. And the battle oftentimes is raging within us. It's falling prey to our temptations. It's falling prey to all the things that we desire not to do really when we understand what is really good for us. And so that battle within us, how do we become strengthened? Well, remember, how do you become strengthened if you want to get fit this summer? Well, we deny ourselves some things, maybe like the food that isn't good for us. And we also, we start to do the things that we ought to do, the things that are hard to do. Not just pleasure, but we start to work out, right? We start to do those things that start to train our body, to chisel our body, to get it to a place where it can be fit and healthy. So we have to deny some things and we have to foster other things, but neither of those things are easy. How do we do it? Well, it's training the will against the body. Remember that our body and our will are at war with one another. Our body always wants pleasure in various different ways. It always wants pleasure. But at the same time, when we deny that for something better, that's when we're actually getting fit for the kingdom, right? And so whether it's for something physical or whether it's we are attempting to become more free, we have to deny ourselves some things. That's called penance, right? Penance makes us stronger. That's why we do it. We also have to foster other things. Those are called virtues. Virtues are those things that strengthen our will so that we can actually be able to choose what's good for us. Remember, if we want to be truly free, our greatest limitation is our concupiscence, our desire to choose disordered things. But there's ways to train that. There's ways to overcome it. And the way that we do that is by denying the things that we ought not do and by fostering those virtues, the things that we desire to do. We can become strong together. We know the way, we know that we're in a battle, we know that life is messy, but we know ultimately we're fighting for freedom.